There are six communication techniques that we teach. They fall within what's called the trust and respect communication system. Today we're covering Flppn. It's Flppn, conversation inventory, fact, story, story, connect and redirect, Jedi mind magic, and trust and respect conversation, or a TRC. Today is Flppn. The purpose behind Flppn is to go from eroded trust, low trust, or broken trust, to increase the level of trust between you and another person. The technique is used is the acronym Flppn, frequent, so often, as many conversations as you can. So if I'm a father and I'm trying to develop some trust and respect with my son, I'm gonna have multiple conversations as often as I can. Low risk, which means I'm not gonna talk to him about his math homework or why he was late last night. It has to be low risk. Go frequent, low risk, personal. It's about my son, not about me. Positive, it's not me complaining or venting or looping. It's him. It's just about him, something uplifting or something he's interested in. And then the most important one is neutral. Now the original frequent, low risk, personal, and positive, I heard from Hank Smith, Dr. Smith, down at Brigham Young University in Provo. And then I talked to him once. We were both presenting at a university in Hawaii. And I showed him what I'm trying to do, and he gave me permission to use his material, but to add neutral on it. Because it doesn't work if you're not neutral. So frequent, low risk, personal, positive, and neutral. Now let me tell you a story of how this works. Some years ago, I was teaching at the Boys and Girls Club. I was teaching a community parenting class, just offering it to the community. Anybody could come. And after the first class, I had a lady raise her hand towards the end of the class, and I had just talked a little bit about communicating with children. And she said, I've got to drive to Spokane tomorrow, which is a 5-hour drive from Gig Harbor, with my then senior in high school daughter, 17, 18 years old. And I really haven't spoken to her since her sophomore year. So it's been 2 years, and I'm scared to death to get in the car with her. I said, okay, give me just an idea of what's going on. Long story short, dad left him when she was very young. Mom tried to raise her as a single mom, going to school, going back to school, getting a job, putting herself in a position where she can earn an income, but emotionally drained probably and frustrated because her daughter's becoming the teenager. So I recommended Flppn, taught it to her right then and said, here's the takeaway on Flppn. No opinions. Don't ask her or don't give her any of your feedback, ideas, thoughts, or judgments. Every time she gives you an answer off of something, ask her a question based on her answer. That's the secret. She'll give you permission to talk to her, permission interviewing, by her answer. So, and then she said, well, what if I can't get her talking? Just be patient, ask her a question, open-ended, and wait. So she did it. She came back a week later. She walked in my classroom, and she came early while I was setting up. And I saw her walk in. I said, oh, tell me how your trip to Spokane went. And she started tearing up. She said, I couldn't believe it. It was rough at first. I tried to ask her questions, and she was her typical self. She wouldn't give me any answers. But I did what you said. I was patient, and I asked some open-ended questions. And when she started telling me, just giving me the slightest answer, I asked her another question based on the answer she gave me. I don't think I did a very good job, but the one thing I did do well is I did not offer an opinion. I didn't should on her. I'm putting these in my words now. I didn't should on her. I didn't judge her. I didn't relate. I didn't condescend. Those are all parts of rules of engagement, if you'll remember. And I said, well, what happened then? She said, my daughter talked to me for 5 hours non-stop. And now she was getting a little bit more teary-eyed. And then on the way back, it was a repeat. I haven't talked to my daughter that much in the previous 2 years. And in one weekend, because I stopped offering an opinion, my daughter started talking to me. Flppn, going from low trust to a higher level of trust. Because you take your opinions, which are almost always unsolicited, out of the mix, and you start following your rules of engagement. It is powerful. I just challenge you. Try it. See what happens if you can practice flippant conversations and don't expect them to reciprocate. Just be yourself and go flippin'. All right, thanks for listening.